Hi guys, hope you are doing well. Today is Sunday. Yesterday I did not have time to analyze the chart, so today is Sunday, so I would want to share my analysis with you guys. So as I told you guys that we're just focusing on US30 and Nasdaq. So as you all know that this index is very volatile. First of all, Nasdaq, it stands for the 100 co largest company in USA. These are the companies that Nasdaq derived from. So that's why it's also very volatile because of the 100 company that they are inside this index. So inside this index, we can find like stocks like Facebook, Alibaba, Amazon, all these big company, Apple. Yeah. So guys, as you know, the secret for this is just to follow the trend. If the market is doing like this, lower, high, higher, low, all you need to know is just to know where is this trend going. Even on the uptrend, just the same thing. So if you don't trade against it, then you're going to be profitable. You're going to make money because you ain't going against the market. So this is how I'm gonna take my trade on Nasdaq this week. Last week it was a good week, even though we took some losses. Yeah, but it was the profit were bigger enough comparing to the losses. So guys, this is Nasdaq. As you guys know that Nasdaq is a market that is always going up. Nasdaq is a market that's always going up. As you can see guys, this is an uptrend. Yeah, this is an uptrend. So what I think Nasdaq is gonna do, Nasdaq is no longer interested in selling. That selling movement, they are done. So now what I think is that this market might now continue or start going up. Yeah. So if it doesn't start going up, then it is what it is. It is what it is. So right now, this is what I see. I see a structure like that. Low, low, high, low, low. I see a structure that was formed that is like this. And then it came. And now it's coming down like this. It's a continuation. But at the same time, as we can see, it was the lower low, low high. This is a lower low. And then this one might be the lower high to continue down. But as we see that when price was coming here, when price was forming this impulse from this lower high to this lower low, we saw that the market was coming like this. It was also creating lower low, lower high. That was the last lower high. Then this was the lower low. So when market came here, it created another lower low. So for me, I won't consider that as an lower low because it did not break this lower low here, the major one. So, hence I'm saying, I think this market is gonna now continue or starting to build a bullish market like this. Understand? So our first target. To do what? To do what?
She touched up blue, she's the one who broke it. Now she was the one who was saying that the touch up blue, now she's coming.
Okay, close the door. Yeah, then so this is what I see. If you guys can see
this might do
that. Yeah, then yeah, so guys, sorry, just the background noise. So this is what we see. If we know that okay, this market is doing something like that, then we're expecting for the market to change direction. That's what we are thinking, or that's what this market is trying to do. It seems like it's changing direction, because when if it this was the low, higher low, and then it created this low, and this high, low, high, low. So this is a sign that it is no longer interested of taking this market down. So maybe now it's going to change, shift direction. So, and we also see an head and shoulder for those who trade patterns like head and shoulder. That is just a sign. If you guys can see, that's just a sign that the market want to go up. Or even if you see that this is a strong hand. For those who like who trade, is the strong hand, is the weaker, and then go. Or they say this is the what is this? Not expand, but there's a normal W, and a normal and an extend. W. So this is the short W, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it is. Yeah, so guys, for me, I think Nasdaq, it want to shift direction, it want to start going up. So these are the level that I'm waiting for the market to reverse from. So for me, what I think Nasdaq, what it's gonna do this week, I'm going to look for a buy opportunity. Yeah, I'm going to look to go long on Nasdaq, because I saw the type of structure that gave me. So now it's coming to retest this low with that failed to create the lower low. Yeah, so it's coming to retest so that it can start going up. So all I want to see is a rejection at these areas. If I see a rejection at these areas, then I'm going to buy. Now on US30, on US30, I see the same, almost like the same type of pattern. So if I go on my, on a 4-hour time frame, if you guys can see, it was, the market was a bullish market. It was doing high low. So then the high low was broken from here. So then that open market came, created a lower low high. Then it broke, it went up, then it came down again. So what happened? That's a sign of trend that the bullish, they want to come into the market. So what am I now expecting from this market is for this market to do something like that. Let me just check my, let me go on the 1 hour time frame. Let me see something. Just want to see something first. Okay. Okay. Let me run the 4 hour time frame. Okay. This is what I see. Okay. So this is the zone that I'm gonna watch. This is the zone that I'm going to watch for USA30. These are the two zones that I'm going to watch where I want the market to reverse. As you guys can see in the 4 hour time frame, we see that this market, it was a bullish market, but then it started failing. It failed from me. This was the last higher low that was broken. And then price came, created a lower low, and then did what? Created a lower low, then created a lower high, then it came here, it failed to create another lower low. So that is a sign that it want to change direction. So in this case, if I come here, I'll see that the market was doing higher low, a high and a low. So, and then it continued going up way. So this was our last high, lower high, this one. And this was our low, but price did not break this low. So now, as long price it remain under this low, we consider this market as a bearish market for now. For now, just for now. We will consider it as a bearish market just for now. Yeah, we'll consider it as a bearish market, but if it breaks above it, then we are going to buy. But also in this case, we can also see that if we come from this lower low, we saw that the price already broke this resistance here, this supply zone, which is a sign that the buyers are strong. So what do? We are expecting for market to come and make a retest here before going up. So in this case, going to my 1 hour time frame, it shows that, let me just adjust something here. Yeah. Okay. So, I'm sorry, you guys, let me just. Okay. So now this is the area where I'm looking. We saw that price broke this supply zone. So if we put our Fibonacci, maybe from here until here, so we are expecting for price maybe to just consolidate the way it's doing to accumulate here before going up. So I don't see a clear clear point with the Fibonacci, so I'll just go with the pure price action. So we know that this was the structure that was broken, which is this one. So now we're expecting for price to come at this point here before taking a back position. Yeah, before taking a back position. So going on a 15 minute, now we want to place our order. This is where we are looking. Don't know, it can come down, it can come more down. But yeah, this is the zone that we are looking, where we want price to come. If price can come at this zone before we buy, just want price to come at this zone before we buy. Yeah, before we buy, we want price to come at this zone. This is the zones that we are going to buy from. This is USA30. Yeah, this is the zone that we are waiting, or we are looking to buy from these zones. Okay, from these zones. All right, this is the zone we are looking to buy USA. Okay, so this target is gonna be here. This way is gonna be our first target. So right now our price is just accumulating, or it's just correcting. Price is just correcting. So what I want to see is just this price to continue doing this correction. If it comes below, then for me is where I want to take a buy position. This target is gonna be here and then proceeding going up. Yeah guys, this is my analyze on NASDAQ and US30. So I hope you guys understood what I said. Don't trade here in this range, don't trade here. Yeah, the market's just choppy. Don't trade there, wait for the market to leave this dead zone. Yeah, so guys, for me, this is what I had to share with you guys. So if you enjoy it, like it and share to your friends who are also interested in learning Forex. And then, yeah, life goes on. So this is what I'll always advise you guys, always to stay focused, never give up. Your days are coming, you know, your days are coming. Just keep pushing, keep pushing. There's no a short success way. You must always cry, you must always suffer before you reach your goals. So guys, for me, this has been to Forex, and take care of yourself. Bye.